we find the funds of Basagidotti in his account. So we'd like to ask more questions regarding that. And then he said that he lost trust in PS Bank. And yet he opened the checking account and redeposited the money. So I think those are questions that we'd like to address to him. And if he says, he's also been saying that he was quite wealthy when he entered public service and that his wife comes from a family of means. Mm-hmm. Our question is, how come it wasn't declared in the SALN?
And si Mrs. Corona, Attorney Salvador, siya yung isa po sa mga ipauupo as a defense witness, di po ba?
Tama po yan.
And when she does explain, or will you require her to explain, ano, yung instances where funds from Basagidotti wound up in the accounts of Chief Justice Corona, and I ask Congressman Angara, sa palagay po ba ninyo, is Mrs. Corona going to be the relevant person to talk about those accounts, or si Chief Justice Corona lang dapat ang may personal knowledge again who can talk about those accounts? Siya lang at hindi si Mrs. Corona.
Ganito po, no, liliwanagin ko lang. Apo. I don't want to sound na iniiwasan ko po.
Yes, po.
Kasi po yung bagay na yan ay tumututok na sa strategiya namin. Kung sino magti-testify ng formal. Kasi po, I hope you understand. Dahil yung mga bagay na yan, ayaw naman namin i-feed and to prompt the prosecutor. Ah, ito palang plano nilang paraan ng pagpresenta nito. Siguro po maliwanag naman na nasabi namin na siya ay iupo sa witness stand.
Yes.
Siguro po magandang hintayin po natin kung ano kanyang sasabihin. Kailangan sabihin. Opo.
Okay. Congressman Angara.
Tony, I think yung pag-present po kay Mrs. Corona is a way of getting the benefits of presenting the Chief Justice without the risks of presenting the Chief Justice. Kasi kung si Chief Justice ho ang nagtitestigo, andun po yung personal knowledge, pwede niyang ipaliwanag po yung kanyang SALN at yung kanilang mga desisyon sa Korte Suprema at ang kanyang naging role doon. But yet, tatanungin din siya ng mga tanong. So I think by presenting Mrs. Corona, they're trying to get the benefits of presenting the Chief Justice without the risks po.
Pero sa palagay nyo, Congressman Angara, would the senator judges or even the Senate presiding officer be within their rights to call Chief Justice Corona to the witness stand? Kung talagang sa tingin nila, siya lang ang makapagpapaliwanag nito mga issues na ito.
Well, I don't know if they would, when you say call, if gagamitin nila yung subpoena power or yung compulsory power. But I think it's clear that they would rather that he testify based on their earlier pronouncements.
Kasi sometimes, and I will ask also Attorney Adele to maybe put this into context. You know, when we talk about, say, impeachment during the time of Bill Clinton, President Bill Clinton, they asked him to submit a deposition, a video deposition, parang just to answer questions from the
correct
special prosecutor. Would that
closed circuit TV.
Through closed circuit TV. Would that be something that you would be looking at, Congressman Angara?
Well, we're not ruling it out if that's what they want to do. I remember President Clinton was advised by his lawyers not to sit not in front of the grand jury and not to accept questions, but he overruled the his advice lawyers. Of his lawyers, and over that advice, I think it was over 6 hours, his testimony.
Yeah, siguro, kay Attorney Tranquil Salvador, may pagkakataong ba na si Chief Justice, ano, after having appeared in several interviews, can he overrule Justice Cuevas and say, eh, nagsalita na ako in public, pwede na ako magsalita in court?
Okay. Para po sa kabatiran ng ating mga kababayan, no? Ganito po kasi ang workings ng isang relasyon ng isang kliyente sa mga abogado niya. Ang kliyente po ay nandyan para magbigay ng facts and information in connection sa kaso niya, kahit po siya isang abogado. Pero po ang strategiya, ang paglalatag ng kanyang kaso, ay desisyon po ng kanyang mga abogado. At siya po ay I would submit to the ultimate decision of his defense team on the need or the necessity of presenting him on the witness stand. Pero po, ayoko po i-discount yung posibilidad na yan. Alam ko po ang ating mga kababayan ay talaga naghihintay. Siguro po, bigyan lang natin ng panahon at makikita nyo po kung paano namin ilalatag ang aming ebidensya. Kung kailangan siya, baka po magulat kayo, nandiyan na lang
magulat
siya.
Iniisip kasi ng tao ata, baka you may need to protect the Chief Justice from himself.
Hindi naman po siguro. I believe that he is a very intelligent person and he would know how to answer the questions to be propounded on him by the counsels and the senator judges. So on that point, I have no fear, except that, of course, we have strategies that we will have to abide on.
All the risks. Ano, sabi niyo, all the benefits without the risks, Congressman Angara? Sabi ni Congressman Angara,
I think that's why they wanted to present Mrs. Corona.
Okay.
But it's interesting, the point you raised,
okay,
Tony.
Just very quick. basically, we were showing file footage earlier of Chief Justice Corona attending the first day of the impeachment trial. That was 27 days ago. Attorney Salvador, is the Chief Justice going to drop by the trial today?
Well, honestly, hindi ko po masasabi. Yung unang araw po, if you would recall, that was January 16, ano?
Yes.
Kahit po kami, marami sa amin nagulat na siya'y pumunta. Tingnan po natin kung siya'y bibisita. Hindi pa naman po siya kailangang testigo sa mga panahon na ito. If he feels that it is necessary for him to join and to see the proceedings, then I think he's free to do that.
Okay, all right. Thank you very much. Go ahead, Congressman.
Karen, yeah. Could I weigh in on that?
Sure.
Let's also remind the public that the Chief Justice has a standing promise to present the dollar accounts at the proper time, made from him unsolicited.
Okay. Oh, attorney, your reaction on that? Oh, nga, the defense said that in court.
There's nothing more to explain. I think this thing speaks for itself, and let's just wait on how the proceedings will progress, and sana naman po napagbigyan nyo naman na kami ng 25 session days para kami po magpresenta. Mm-hmm. Siguro naman ho ang ilang araw ay hindi too much to ask.
All right.
Para magpresenta po kami.
Just one last question before I turn you over to Linda and Adele. We've been hearing that there are 2 weeks left. Congressman Sunny and Attorney Salvador, you can answer this now. There are 2 weeks left before they go on recess, and the Senate has decided that if the defense is not finished, the continuation of the presentation of your evidence will be on May 6. Do you agree with that, Attorney Salvador? I mean, does that work for the defense?
Well, kailangan ho namin respetuhin ang session days no ng ating legislative body. Ang pagkakaalam ko nga po ay 8 session days na lamang po ang naiiwan dito.
Uh-oh.
At hindi po namin masasabi kung gaano kabilis ang magiging takbo po nito dahil hindi lang naman po kami magsasalita at walang cross-examination. May cross-examination po ito at ang 23 senator judges po pwede rin silang magtanong. At tandaan niyo po, they're entitled to 2 minutes each.
Okay.
Now, so, mahirap po sabihin at this time.
Don't you want a request for that extra week before Holy Week? I'm just curious so that you can close it properly.
Palagi ko po, narinig ko na rin ng isang senator judge na interview kaninang umaga na napakahirap ata noon at hindi ko lang alam kung papasok sa kanilang schedule. Alam niyo naman, kami sumusunod lamang sa mga patakarang ng impeachment court. So we just face the issue as it comes po.
Mm-mm. I'm curious, how many witnesses are you presenting? Just a rough figure.
Well, I think in the light of the adjustments and the dropping of the 5 articles, para po mga 15 hanggat 20 na lang po yan. Ay somewhere around that area.
Okay.
Ang aming po ipipresentang testigo po.
I see. Okay. Attorney Salvador, Congressman Angara, thank you very much. Linda,
salamat
Adele.
Po.
Salamat right, and coming up next, we'll be taking a look back at the prosecution's presentation of Articles 2, 3, and 7. Stay tuned for that.
Keep us company. This is Chief Justice on Trial, the ANC coverage.